forget to do my brows? I did, didn't I? Wow. I like that. A lot. So yay me. Which shade I want in my inner corner? Ooh. Did you see that? My coffee spit at me. Wow. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, 6 looks with the Avocado palette by iHeart Revolution. I'm going to keep it quick and short, otherwise I will be here and you will be here tomorrow as well. Usually I go row by row with my looks. This time I did not. I just went playing. So I created 6 looks and they are all, I think, very, very different. I don't really have a favorite. But yeah, grab a drink, grab a snack. Oh yeah, timestamps will be down in the description box below. And I will try and list the makeup that I have on my face for each of the looks as well. So yeah, check out my description box for extra information. And for now, you know, just grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one. Well, hello and welcome to the first look with the Avocado palette. Face is ready, eyes are primed with the MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. And I am going to start with the color called Half. And yeah, that's going to go on my lid or in my crease, but maybe a little bit more in the lower crease. Does that make any sense? So let me get a brush. Why not? Let me get this one for funsies, which is one from BH Cosmetics. It is the number 6. It's just a bigger fluffy brush than I usually use, but it does not really matter. So let's get the color. It is a bit powder in the pan, but I knew that. I'm going to press it on because I haven't set my base. And okay then, she not playing. Done. No, that was not sped up, no cutting, done. Wow. Okay then. I have here a flat brush, which is also a little bit fluffy. The color Half is going to go underneath my eye as well. I do need to blend it out a little, so let me get a different brush for that. Let me get my really, really soft brush. And just blend out the edge a bit before I go in with the next shadow. I have here the Morphe M514 and I'm going to go into the color Lime. I kind of need to place it a little bit first because I haven't set the base. Now, because this is quite a light shade, I'm dipping in constantly. I'm using a fluffy brush with a light shade. So yeah, this is showing up the way I wanted to, but it is light. With the same brush, I'm going to go back in the color Half to define the crease a little bit. Okay, I'm going to darken it up a tad with the color called Huss, which looks like a black, but it's actually a very dark green. I'm using my Morphe M507, just the tip. I'm just going to place it in the outer corner. I'm going to drag whatever I have left there into the crease a little so it is nice and blended. I'm just building up this shadow onto the darkness that I wanted, basically. I'm just taking my time for this, and this is actually the longest part of the whole look. Well, that and eyeliner, I think, but cute. Okay, it is time for the shimmer and coffee. I have my NYX glitter glue and flat brush. I'm going to pat it on where I want the shimmer. You don't have to do it like this. I do, however, find that as Betty Jean says, actually, the shimmers are more intense this way. Okay, then I'm going to go into the color Stone. Just with the same brush, I'm just going to go in there. I don't have to spray it now. This one is a little bit harder pressed than some of the other shimmers, it looks like. Oh, very pretty. I'm going to, here in the corner, I'm going to tap it over. I did not put glitter glue there, so it can easily blend. Or blend a bit easier, whatever you want to call it. I like this shade a lot, actually. Okay, I'm switching brushes back to the one that I used just previously and back in the color Haas, which is a dark green, to blend the edge here. Just going to drag it over the shimmer shade and then drag that shimmer shade back a bit. So I'm just wiggling. Yeah. Pretty. Oh, that's such a pretty olivey green. Gorgeous. Yes, I want that underneath my eye as well, actually. So I have here a lip brush. I'm going to spray it now because I want to see what that does, and I'm going to place it on my lash line. Oh, that's so pretty. Yeah. Okay, a little bit of the color Haas here as well. For inner corner, I'm going to use the color Pear. Or Pear, Pear. I think it's Pear. Now I'm just blending and tapping and making sure it's nice. Basically, I can also do it with my finger. Oh, that's even better. Foreliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For mascara, the Catrice Glam and Doll Lash Growth Volume Boost Mascara. And here is the look before the falsies. For falsies, the Social Glam Lash in Style London. For lips, Revolution X Soft Lipstick in Syrup. And then that concludes the look. I like it a lot, actually. The rest of my makeup will be listed down below. This was the first look. Let's get ready for the next one. Well, hello and welcome to another look with the avocado palette. Please hold on to something, because I'm going to do a neutral look today. Yeah. I'm going to start with a dense brush, but not too big. Then the color called Toast. That's going to go outer corner and in the crease, and we will see from there. I'm going to start in the outer corner. I'm going to tap it on all through the crease. Okay, I'm going to take a different brush to blend out. I have here a big fluffy one. I'm going to use that to blend out the edge. This one's really, really soft. I'm going to take a little bit of the color Toast that I just used to help blend here a bit. A little bit more of the color Toast and blend lower. So now I'm just blending on top of the color I just put down, just to make sure it's not patchy and all that. Okay, I'm taking my Morphe, what is it, 507, and the same color Toast. I'm going to intensify it in the crease just a little bit. Let's grab a pencil brush into the same color Toast, and I want it underneath my eye, but high. Yeah, down. I still have a little bit of green on that brush. Now, because I had a little bit of green on my brush anyway, I'm going to go into the color Haas. I'm going to use it a tiny bit to deepen up the outer V, just with this brush. I'm just placing it, and then I'm leaving it alone. I will blend it in a minute. Now, this brush is clean. I'm going to blend the two colors together because I want a little bit of depth, but not a lot of color there. And I'm blending it in, if that makes any sense. So I'm kind of flicking it in and taking it through the crease a bit. Now I'm taking a little bit of the color Toast, the brown, and I'm going to put it on top. And as you can see, it's not really green anymore. It's more of a darker brown now and gives a nice definition to the eye. Let's blend everything in together. Yeah, let's go to the shimmers now. Let me get my glitter glue. I'm all over the place. I have the NYX glitter glue. It's going to go on my lid. I'm tapping it on where I'm going to put the shimmers. First shimmer I'm going to use is the color called Mousse. It's going to go on the outer part of my eye. And then kind of make sure it's nice here in the corner. I want it a little bit diagonally. I don't know why, but I tend to like that lately. Okay, yes. I'm going to go into another shade now called California, which is the gold. Or at least it looks a bit orange in the pan, but when you swatch it, it swatches gold. But it is a very pretty shade. And then on the border, I'm just going to make sure they mix. So I'm dipping one side of my brush in the color Mousse, which was the brown. The other side I have the gold. Just going to go back and forth just to make sure that they mix. I'm going to blend the crease a bit. My brush is clean. Just going to make sure it's nice. So for inner corner highlight, I'm going to grab the color Pear, which does have a tiny hint of green in it. But I think that's cute. For eye pencil, the L'Oreal Infallible Gel Crayon in Super Cooper. With a small brush, the color Mousse. I thought it was going to be a simple look, but I'm not. Just going to smudge it out. For eyeliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For mascara, the Catrice Glam and Doll Boost Lash Growth Volume Stuff thingy. Here's the look before the falsies. With a dramatic neutral look needs to go a dramatic falsie. So for falsies, the So Glam Lash Collection in Milan. For lipstick, the Essence This Is Me in the color Smart. I actually liked it better before my eyebrows, really. And after having done my eyebrows, this is the finished look. I like it. The neutral look kind of succeeded. It is a bit more dramatic than I was going for, but what else is new? I like it. I feel pretty in it. So yeah, let me know down below how you feel about this look. And let's get ready for the next one. Look 3, and today it's going to be green, but a little bit lighter. That's the plan. Yes, eyes are primed and ready to go, and I'm going to start with the color called Lime. I am going to start with quite a denser brush, same brush I started with in my last look, and I'm going to pack the color Lime on. I'm going to deepen it up with a brown later. But for now, let's just put this on the eyeball. I haven't set my base, so I'm going to tap it on. I'm going to start high. So above my natural crease. I'm dipping back in the pan regularly to get more pigment and to just press it on my eye. And as you can see, I'm kind of creating a wing shape already. It's because I know I want to deepen it up there. But I'm just creating the shape. Okay, I also want it underneath my eye. And now I'm just going to blend the edge. Just to make sure that it flows nicely, you know? I don't need a lot of blending on the green. It's just I want it to be as vibrant as possible. And I'm just blending the edges. I'm going to take a different brush. This one is small and a little bit fluffy. But also flat. It's a weird one, but it's a nice one nonetheless. I'm going to go into the color Seed to deepen it up a tiny bit, give it a little bit of definition in the outer corner and in the crease. I could use a green for that, but I don't want to. I'm also tapping this on here because now I'm going to a part of my eye that I haven't set yet. There's no shadow there. I'm just going to tap it on lightly and then drag it a little bit forward into the crease. Blend it on the edge. Taking a little bit of lime again. I'm going to blend over it. How's that looking? Yes, that is what I want. It's just a hint of something, you know? For the shimmer, I want the color Pear, and it is so pretty. Okay. That was very, very random, wasn't it? Where's my brush? So I have my brush, I have my NYX Glitter Glue. It's going to be like I am doing in the entire video, and that is basically wherever I put down the shimmer, there's going to be a little bit of glitter glue. I'm placing it quite low because I don't want that brown that I just put down to be covered up by the glitter glue. Now I'm going to go into the color Pear. Oh, this is pretty. Okay, I'm taking this brush. I'm going to go into the color Seed, the brown. I'm going to make sure that it flows kind of nicely here. Okay, almost done. I am taking my very, very small brush, the Morphe E36, in the color Seed. It's going to go underneath my eye as well a bit. With the same brush, I'm going to go into the color Pear, which I put on the lid. I'm just going to place it here around the tear duct a little. And, well, you see what I'm doing, I hope. I haven't sprayed it or anything because I want this to be as sheer as possible. I want a tiny bit of definition back, so I'm going to go into the color Seed, which was the brown, and I'm just making sure that I have it here on that border. I like that a lot. So yay me. For eyeliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For mascara, the Catrice Glam and Doll Lash Growth Volume Boost Stuff, whatever. And here is the look just before the falsies. Very, very pretty. I don't need falsies, but I do want them today. And we are going to keep it soft. So for falsies, the Sosus in Style London. So falsies on, lippy on, here is the finished look. I like it. It is nice and fresh and summery. And I just paired it. Oh, I forgot to show you the lippy, didn't I? It's the clear gloss from Pouty Lips. It's actually the only clear gloss that I have. And it does pout the lips. Yes. Hair. But anyway, I like how it turned out. I think it is nice and fresh and summery and all that goodness. So this was look number 3, I think. I think it was, yes. Let's get ready for the next one. Okay, dokie, look number 4, I think. Today is going to be hot as hell, while tomorrow is going to be worse, I think. But I'm going to go for the soft neutral look with a pop of green in this case. So I have primed my eyes with the MAC Paint Pot in soft ochre. Let me get a brush and think about how I want to. I want to do something I usually don't do, and that is kind of set my eyeshadow base, because I want just a light layer, and I think that will make my life a lot easier. I'm taking a very fluffy brush and the color called Creamy. I'm going to set my eyeshadow base. I know, it's really shocking. I think it's the heat. Anyway, just going to tap it on first on the lid and then in the crease as well. Okay, let's stick with this brush for now and go to the color called Toast. I know this is a pretty big brush, but I kind of want to lay down a wash of color first. So what I'm actually using are the tips, not the whole fluffy part, just the tip. and I'm going to run it in the crease to give a little bit of definition to the eye. And my base is still sticky. I can feel that, so I need a little bit more. And again, it's just the tips. Let's switch brushes to one that is a little bit smaller, or a lot smaller actually. The Morphe M506, and I'm still using the color Toast, the brown that I just used, a tiny bit, because I need a little bit more definition and darkness here in the crease and the outer corner. Not too much, in order to be a light look today. It's not the first time I'm saying that. Yeah, I'm going to build it up a tiny bit in my outer corner and on my lid. I'm just flicking it in. And I want, when I look forward, to be able to see that hint of brown. I think that's it. Tiny bit underneath my eye, or at least in the outer corner part. Now you can build this up in the outer corner if you wanted to. I am not going to though. Let's see if I am happy with how it is looking here. Not really. I need a little bit more because this part looks patchy. I'm just kind of depositing a little bit of color there. It's a problem area for me, that part, so it's not really weird. I want a little bit of that color Creamy, the first shadow I used. I'm just going to blend here. I don't want that brown higher. I want it to be a little bit more diffused though on top. And that is when a shadow like this is perfect. Very, very soft. And that is actually what I wanted. Now I need to kind of figure out which shade I want in my inner corner. Ooh. Did you see that? My coffee spit at me. Wow. Ooh. That is what you get when you pour in hot coffee in the mug and don't do the squeezy thing. Anyway,
Ooh, that is a pretty color.
I think I'm going to go with this one, which is Foodie. So, let me get a pencil brush. I'm going to go into the color Foodie. That is going to go in my inner corner. With a different brush, let's get this one that I used, kinda in the color Foodie again, just to make sure it is a little bit more blended. Okay, let's grab a pencil, BH Cosmetics Power Pencil in teal. Cute. I have a little bit on my brush still of that shimmery shade. Let's just kinda what do you call it again? Blend? Wow. I think that is nice and cute in summer. So yes. For eyeliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For a mascara, the Catrice Glam & Doll Waterproof. And here is the look with liner and mascara. I specifically chose a wing because I like wings with this kind of looks. It's maybe a little bit more dramatic than I was going for, but what else is new? If you want to keep it softer, either don't do a wing or keep the wing smaller and do dolphins instead of whales, you know? Okay. For falsies, the So Glam Lash Collection in London. For lips, the Pouty Lips Clear Lip Gloss. And then this concludes the look. I like it. It's nice and summery. It's simple and quick. I have been filming for 24 minutes, 25 minutes. And that's including putting on the falsies. So this is a pretty quick look. And I like the effect that the lip gloss gives with me applying it on top of, well, basically my foundation. So you get a very light, nude, glossy lip that way. So, yeah. I like it. Let me know down below how you like it, and let's get ready for the next look. Yeah. Is everything working? Yes. Okay, look number I think it's 5. And background noise, it's hot, windows open, fan is on. That's, oh yeah, and I think it's garbage day, but I'm not sure, so that's basically what's happening outside. I'm going to do a look that I've wanted to do ever since I opened up the palette. And that is basically the color Haas all over the lid or all over my eye, blended out with this one for the edges, and then a shimmer on the lid. That's it. Simple. I hope a little bit quick as well, but we will see. I have primed my eyes with the MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. I am going to put down a soft wash of color first. So I'm going to take my fluffy brush in the color Haas. That's going to go all over the lid. I'm probably not going to talk a lot because they are making a noise outside. But we shall see. I don't mind this going on my lid though. I'm going to put a shimmer on top of it anyway. Basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to blend it here, make it somewhat softer, and then darkening into the crease. A lot of blending involved basically. With a flat fluffy brush, okay, soft layer down, now I'm going to build it up. For that, I am taking a smaller brush. This is the Morphe M507. I'm still using the color Haas. This is going to go in the crease outer corner. I'm going to build up the darkness. That sounds really dramatic, but yeah. Let's see how dark we can get this shade, shall we? Looks like this, even though they are simple, are going to take time because you're basically blending a lot. And what I'm doing is I'm placing the shadow and then blending the edge up a little bit just to make sure that it is nice and seamless without losing that depth a little bit lower. Okay, I'm switching to the first brush to just go over everything and make sure that this layer is nice. Okay, smaller brush still, the Morphe E36. There we are, still the same color. Let's see if we can deepen it up even more. I don't think so though. I think I'm at its maximum depth. I hope it doesn't slide off my face because it's freaking warm here. I like this. Let's get my beauty blender and kinda do that. Get that shape. Nice. I'm actually really impressed by this shade. It's not patchy, blends out nicely. It's a good palette, people. Okay, what I want to do now is I want to blend the top edge a little bit more, but for that I'm taking a different brush and I'm taking the color Creamy. Because this is almost my skin tone, I can nicely use this to blend out the shade without bringing the green up too high. I want that dark green a little bit higher here, so with just with the same brush that I'm using, I'm dipping into the color Haas because I want a light layer. Just to make sure that it is nice and flowy and the way that I want it. Yes, that's it. Okay, now I need to decide what shimmer I want to use on my eye. I'm going to take a flat brush, my NYX Glitter Primer, and that's going to go on my eyelid before I'm going to go in with the shimmer. Okay, and then I'm going to go into the shimmer called Bite. Going to go on my lid. This is a pretty chunky formula, so let's see what it does. Yeah, you need to layer this one. or spray it, I think. Okay. Different brush and the color Haas, that green matte, just to blend the edges here. And put it a little bit over. I did leave the inner corner blank, I'm well aware. I'm taking a different brush and I'm going to go into the color Smash. That is going to go as my inner corner highlight and a little bit on top of the inner part where I left the spot open. For underneath my eye, I'm going to spray this shade, still the color Smash. Okay, tiny bit more of that green matte for here, just to make sure it flows nicely. Both eyes done. Let's finish everything off, shall we? For eyeliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For mascara, the Catrice Glam & Doll Volume Boost Lash Growth Stuff. For falsies, the Sosu Glam Lash in Milan. For lipstick, the Miss Young Fashion Matte in 11. And here is the finished look. I like it. I think it is nice and dramatic, hence the dramatic falsies. I think the lippy offsets it nicely. This was one of the looks that I had in mind for this video. Let me know down below how you like it. And let's get ready for, I think it's going to be the last one. Yeah, so sad. Here it comes. The last look of the video. It should be a simple one. I primed my eyes with the MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre. And I'm going to start with a fluffy brush. This is from BH Cosmetics. It is their number 6. I'm going to take the color Lime. It's going to go everywhere, basically. I haven't set my eyeshadow base, as I usually do not. So I'm going to tap it on first. And because this is a fluffy brush, I need to dip in constantly, but that doesn't matter. Now I'm just softly blending the edges. A little bit of Lime. Also want it underneath my eye. Just going to tap a little bit more in the low crease. And because this brush is a bit bigger, it kind of diffuses it up. Done. Other eye. Okay. I want it a little bit more kind of packed on underneath my eye. So I'm taking a smaller brush for that. I'm going to go to the shimmer. I know, it's quick, isn't it? I'm taking a flat brush, my NYX Glitter Glue, and I'm putting it over my eye, just basically as I have done the whole video. Then I'm going to go into the color Green Gold, going to go on my lid. Cute. I want it underneath my eye as well. I'm going to spray for there. I'm going to take a tiny bit of Guacamole just to darken up the outer corner and pull it together a bit. Not too much, just a tiny bit. Yes, okay, other eye. For inner corner highlight, I'm going to take the color Pear. Small brush, I'm going to spray it and it's going to go in my inner corner just for a little bit extra oomph. Eye pencil is going to be the ColourPop cream gel liner in, it's the electric green one, I don't know. It has it rubbed off, people. For eyeliner, the Revolution Renaissance Flick. For falsies, the Sosu Glam Lash Collection in London. For lips, the NYX Intense Butter Gloss in Cookie Butter. And then here is the finished look. I like it. It's nice and summery and fresh and I feel like an apple. I don't know why. I just do. But yeah, guys, this was the last look of the video. It's so sad. It's so sad. Let me know down below if you have a favorite. I don't think I do, actually. Although, I do have to say, I did feel really, really pretty in actually the most neutral look of the video. You know, that was look 4, I think it was. Yeah, I felt really pretty in that one. But I felt pretty in all of them, so I don't really have a favorite this time around. Although I really like this one as well. But yeah, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. If you have not seen the review yet, I will link it because it is up. Go check it out when you are done watching this. I thank you so freaking much for watching. Gonna wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one. Bye guys.